years old, which one of them has the biggest future in front of him? Those shorts, Shwethwaiti, pulled up very high, and he pulls him up again, almost up to his chest there. Very, very Muay Thai style, isn't it?
Yeah, we've got a Muay Thai fighter against a Litway fighter, and they are getting ready to put on a show. You can see the aggressive kicks immediately coming out of Pongsiri. He's calling it in, saying, no problem. Just let me see what you got.
Looks very calm about the whole thing, the Burmese fighter, doesn't he?
I mean, when you've been in there that many times, yeah. It's just another day at the office. But this is a completely different environment. The media, the press, you know, the atmosphere, the energy, the buzz. It's completely different when you get inside a one championship cage.
Particularly when it's the first time that a major mixed martial arts organization has come to this country. There has been so much media activity.
Pongsiri Mitsatit is throwing some heavy, heavy leg shots right now. You can see he's just chambering that right leg and letting it go.
And that lead leg for Shwethwaiti is taking a bit of a battering. Keeps that guy, that guard nice and high though, but that left leg is taking another punishment. Brings up that knee to the head, and that guard went very well for him.
Shoots in, gets the takedown. Now we get to see what Shwethwaiti is like, gonna be off of his back. Pongsiri Mitsatit slides easily into half guard. Shwethwaiti's kind of holding on to that head, just kind of securing the position. Doesn't really have a choke there.
Yeah, can he do any damage with
that
pitch?
Yeah, I mean, it's a very rare. Actually, the guy on top, you know, has a choke from there, but he's with his arm in that position. There's not a lot. It would take a lot of power to crank on that neck from this position.
Looks very calm, Shwethwaiti, has his mouth closed all of the time. There he is, just getting about his business, focusing hard.
But he's got to push away from the head. He's, I mean, because Pongsiri is kind of giving him space on the side, so he's able to turn onto his side like that. But he's got to push away, create space, and get back up to where he's probably much more comfortable, and that's on his feet. And he slides his knee in to protect. That's good. He's in a bad spot.
Oh my goodness. Big, big heavy knees. The guard is in place, but it's so difficult to stop knees of that heaviness. Wow.
Yeah, that was a bad position. And once he got in that side control position, he just started dropping those knees in. And it was, Yuji Shimada had no choice but to call a hot to that fight.
And the fans love that. Pongsiri Mitsatit improves his record to 7-0. These left-way fighters are very accomplished in their own sport. They have a few steps to make to become true mixed martial artists. And that extra experience that Pongsiri has in the MMA cage, 6 undefeated contests before he stepped into this cage, just served him very well indeed. And that barrage of right knees to the head, really, after the first 3 or 4 had landed, there was something inevitable about Yuji Shimada stepping in to call it a day. So, big start for the fans here in Thailand. 2 of their own victors.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Yuji Shimada calls a halt to this battle at 2:24 of round number 1 for your winner. Via referee stoppage due to strikes, Pongsiri Mitsatit!
Great noise from the Impact Arena here. The fans really getting into it. Some crowds in Asia like to stay pretty quiet and just focus on the action. Others really get behind the fighters, and the latter is certainly the case here.
Mitsatit hoping to remain undefeated. Round 1. And with a touch of gloves, both fighters engage, and immediately a right round kick there from Mitsatit, sitting on the outside so far, Mitch.
Yeah, Katsalon looks really relaxed. Mitsatit has just a little bit more experience when it comes to competitive mixed martial arts, and he looks very comfortable in front of his hometown here in Thailand. So we're gonna expecting to see a lot of good things from Mitsatit. His coaches has been speaking this guy high his praises because he's just such a hard worker. Every single day he's improving and getting better and learning all aspects of mixed martial arts.
And the talk of the locker room is that over time he's looked to not only use his Muay Thai base, but set up that striking with a little bit more intelligence and ring awareness for MMA.
Yeah, you know, you can see his guard is a bit high. He's got that Muay Thai stance. You know, nice and relaxed, consistently moving forward. Both these fighters have their shorts hitched up a little bit, so you can see definitely the Muay Thai influence from both these guys. Catalan looks to be just kind of waiting. He knows how dangerous Mitsatit is, and he's just kind of, looks like he's just sort of picking his shots, waiting for the right time to unload.
And possibly trying to pull the counter there as Catalan steps in off that inside low kick to an overhand right. But right now, it would seem to me that Mitsatit more capable in controlling the distance. And there's the shot from Catalan into the clinch.
I like how he set that up with a little bit of that lead leg kick and shot right in for the clinch. Didn't really go for the double leg, but just wanted to initiate and really close the distance from that spacing that he was kind of giving Mitsatit, allowing him to relax a little bit. But now he's into the clinch. So let's see what Mitsatit's like into the clinch.
And always an interesting point in a Muay Thai contest is when both athletes clinch up for the first time. 50-50 here so far. And you can see Catalan wants to stay on this position. He would not want his back up to the mesh, Mitch.
Yeah, he's trying. Now he's got both underhooks where he has both arms underneath the arms of Mitsatit, which is, you know, now he's lost that. Mitsatit goes back into the plum, the tie clinch there. And Catalan immediately transitions down to a single leg. Tries to step over for a head and arm throw, and he lands it, but Mitsatit ends up on top.
Incredible work there by Mitsatit, and his base is so strong for MMA, not only with the wrestling he's been working on, but certainly the grappling skills, those underrated skills from Muay Thai. Mitsatit thinking about maybe catching a leg drag here. Catalan in some early trouble, Mitch.
Yeah, he looks to be okay. He looks comfortable on the ground. That's a big right hand thrown by Mitsatit, so he's just kind of setting that up. He's got to be careful he doesn't jump into an up kick, though. Trying to pass the guard, you know, controlling the leg very well.
And good moves here from Mitsatit. So certainly the results of that hard work, and a big right hand again lands. Catalan covering up, though, avoiding the worst of it so far, Mitch.
I like how he throws the leg off to the side and then steps over with the right hand. So he evades the possible up kick while landing a big right hand of his own. I'm surprised Catalan's letting him control that leg the way that he's doing, because he seems to have a very good grip on his right foot there. See how he throws that leg and drops that big hand again?
And again, Mitsatit goes 2-on-1 on the leg to the overhand. Catalan trying to fight for a leg. Mitsatit steps away. Hammer fist from Mitsatit. Man, what an incredible start. And the Thai crowd, Mitch, loving it so far.
Yeah, they're definitely cheering on their hometown boy. Now Catalan's trying to lace under it, but Mitsatit actually stepped on his hand as Catalan was trying to defend there. You can see him, you know, trying to tangle up the legs a little bit, but Mitsatit's doing a good job of really just defending and countering quite well. And Yuji Shimada's had enough, and he wants them back up on their feet.
And an applause from the extremely well-educated crowd here in attendance tonight at the Impact Arena. Both fighters certainly know what's at stake thus far, and a huge right again lands for Mitsatit. Catalan definitely wants to stay out of the clincher off his back here.
Yeah, he gets into the clinch. Mitsatit jumped in with a flying knee, just kind of caught the body a little bit of Catalan. That seems to be his most successful move, is that head and arm throw to end up on top. He's just not able to control Mitsatit because he's so squirrely on the ground.
And this was one of the problems that I was seeing in the clinch. It's the control of the Thai plum as the knees come into the midsection. Yuji Shimada watching carefully here. Could this be it? Catalan looks in trouble here, Mitch. Catalan falls over and a huge right hand. He turns away and that's the end.
That was beautiful. The knees from the clinch did the damage. Catalan did not like that. And then he just jumped in with a big right hand. Let's take a look at some of that action where he was able to secure another win and remain undefeated. Here, Catalan went in for that head and arm throw. He wasn't happy with the clinch, but then Mitsatit just unloaded him, a barrage of knees. And you can see how much trouble Catalan was in when he started to defend and drop the knees down. But Mitsatit did not let up and just uncorked on him. And it was just a matter of time before Catalan went down right about there. And then Mitsatit just puts the icing on the cake with some big right hands, and Yuji Shimada is forced to jump in and save the day. What a fight, Chris.
Incredible fight, and sticking with the traditions of Muay Thai. Once he had him, he never let him off the hook. Mitsatit victorious. An incredible victory here. The crowd loving it. Here's Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 4 minutes and 45 seconds in the first round. For your winner by way of referee stoppage due to strikes from the red corner, Pongsiri Mitsatit.
So the smiling assassin, Pongsiri Mitsatit, gets another win and makes it 8-0. The 20-year-old, a very bright future indeed. From Team Quest.
Pongsiri Mitsatit, first round knockout, overhand right. The Muay Thai champion of Northern Thailand in the black trunks. On the right of screen. Both men just tipping their feet in the water early here. Miyado said he's happy to stand and trade with Pongsiri Mitsatit.
Guys have massive records in their respective striking arts. It'll be very interesting to see how these two engage each other and really just kind of test the waters.
Miyada was wary of keeping out of the clinch game of Mitsatit, but staying standing in a kickboxing range, not necessarily in a Muay Thai range. Uppercut misses the target, almost took out the ring lights.
Catches the flying knee and immediately gets into that clinch. So I know that's what he said he doesn't want to do, but he's got to create a little bit of distance. Use that jab and get moving around. He doesn't want to stand there like a stationary target.
Pongsiri Mitsatit, 7 out of 8 first round wins.
Mitsatit loves the knees. He likes to fly in with the knees. And immediately as Miyado shoots in, he lands one. But now he gets put on his back. This is unfamiliar territory for Mitsatit. He goes for that heel hook you were speaking about, Michael.
Back to their feet. Beautiful combination from Miyado. Got off some power salvo. Miyado with confidence in the opening 90 seconds. Threads those long arms, hoping to land to the jaw of Mitsatit. Outside leg kick, overhand right from Pongsiri Mitsatit. Put for the Muay Thai clinch of the high knee.
I like the dirty boxing of Miyado, but he's got to be careful inside that clinch, because when he starts swinging wildly with those punches, he's leaving himself perfectly open for a knee.
Miyado keeping his distance at the moment. Wild bolo punch and a short right hand, smack bang on the jaw. Threads out the left. Mitsatit ties him up, tries to pull the head down. Tried to go for the headache maker. Spinning back fist from Miyado. And the crowd appreciating the beautiful technique we're seeing in the striking match.
Both these guys are very relaxed and they're kind of letting their skills really be showcased. Nice takedown from Miyado to end up in the guard of Mitsatit.
Halfway through the opening round, set for 3.
Triangle. Miyado's trying to shrug it off, past the guard.
Mitsatit does have one submission, a 100% finishing right.
Setting up that heel hook again.
Nice up kick, and Miyado walks away. Beautiful right hand there from Mitsatit. Miyado on the outside now. Mitsatit controlling center cage. Jump walking right hand from the Thai. Short knee, looks for the liver. Miyado takes him down inside the guard here of the Thai.
Again, big takedown from Miyado to control the top position. Looks like he's got a little bit of damage going on there, but Mitsatit's landing those short elbows.
Those elbows of Mitsatit are razor sharp. Miyado postures up now. Butterfly hook, 1 foot on hip from Mitsatit. Miyado trying to drop an elbow of his own.
Okay. Again, short elbows there landed by Mitsatit. Miyado's trying to bury his head into the chest, but it's also leaving him available for those short elbows.
Chance for Mitsatit to get back to his feet. And Miyado allows him to do so.
Hands up.
Intriguing opening round with 1 minute 15 remaining. Early on, it was Pongsiri Mitsatit who seemed to have the momentum on his side with the striking. But over the last minute or so, we've seen Miyado come on strongly. Wherever you're watching, in 128 countries around the world broadcast to potentially over 1 billion people. We hope you're enjoying Hero's Dream live from Yangon, Myanmar, in front of a sellout audience. And that said, Mitch, in all my career commentating on combat sports, I have never seen nor heard an audience like we have here in Yangon. This place is electrifying.
Yangon are some serious martial arts fans. They love it. They thrive in it. And if you have not been to a ONE Championship event, you have got to come see this thing live.
Back underway. Mitsatit trying to stay in the center of the cage. They clinch up. Good short right hook, then fades away to Miado. Spinning back fist, he telegraphed it. Mitsatit looks for the body tuck under from Miado. Can he affect the takedown? No.
Takedown defense by Mitsatit to kind of save himself from that single leg. Start pushing the head out and slide that leg out.
Very evasive from the 21-year-old Pongsiri Mitsatit from Chiang Mai, Thailand. Edges forward, flat-footed, overhand right from Miado. Nowhere near the target.
Miado's got to start disguising his strikes a little bit better. He's really just opening up with these one big shots, like that spinning back fist, like that big right hand. Throw that jab out there, set something up. Give him something else to look at. Maybe some leg kicks. Jab, leg kick. Start putting together some combinations.
Nice counter right hand. Doubles up in it. Second one to the jaw there from Mitsatit. The Thai hopes for a takedown. Throws a knee to the midsection. Doubles up. There's a third. Good ending to the round there from Pongsiri Mitsatit.
Mitsatit so strong in that clinch. Miado did land some takedowns though. Did control the top position. Here he is going for that Ashigari, where he's attempting a leg lock, but Mitsatit rolls back out. So this is the round where he said he was gonna get that leg lock, but we'll see. Look at this close boxing range there, where Mitsatit gets it nice and tight. Goes in for the clinch, but Miado just runs right through it to land another takedown. Interesting first round from both these two strikers.
Miado predicted a second round leg lock victory. Pongsiri Mitsatit predicted a first round knockout with the overhand right. You can also see a little hematoma just popping up over the left eye there of Pongsiri Mitsatit. Nothing though to be concerned about as we roll into the second set for three. Two athletes with a high finishing rate, indeed Mitsatit 100%. 8-0, he has finished everybody. Yuji Shimada gets us back underway. Let's see if Miado can use his length here. Very long legs, very long arms. Just backs off. Got to watch the overhand right here of Mitsatit. It was a bit of a scooping right followed by a short left, and Miado says he didn't hurt me. Miado tries for an overhand right of his own. Outside leg kick, right hand over there from Mitsatit. Just a little half grin on the face here of Pongsiri Mitsatit. Really enjoying himself out there, Mitch.
They call him the smiling assassin for a reason. He's always got that grin on his face. He enjoys his time inside the cage, relishes this moment, and thrives off the fans' energy. Big diving takedown from Miado as he presses Mitsatit up against the cage.
Nice tie clinch and knees here. Domination in the clinch from Mitsatit. Miado knew that that was one of the main weapons of Pongsiri, the Muay Thai clinch and knees.
He's so strong in that clinch, Michael, and you can see Miado just kind of runs away from it, but he backs up away from it, so he's got to be careful not to drop his hands because the smiling assassin might come in with one of those big flying knees.
Miado did tell us yesterday he'd try to counter Mitsatit's kicks and then look for the takedown. But he feels that he's okay so long as he stays in this sort of kickboxing range. Looping left hand from Miado, telegraphing.
But he's trying to close the distance by running in with these big punches, and he's not really landing or really closing the distance. So, and you can see Pongsiri Mitsatit kind of waving his head at him like he got nothing on him.
A little bit of showboating there from Pongsiri, just trying to sucker in Miado. He wants Miado elbow to come into range. Tries to launch into range via a flying knee there. This is a very patient contest from Jeremy Miada. He's not going to be suckered into a brawl with this young gun.
Action.
And referee Yuji Shimada wants to see more action. So too does the South crowd here in Yangon. High kick from Pongsiri. Now they're two to two. Pongsiri trying to walk down Miada. Miada backs away. Good little sidestep from Pongsiri, cuts off the cage. Miada backs up against the fence here. Oh, takes the outside thigh kick, buckled his knee. Gotta watch out for the leg lock here, does Pongsiri.
Beautiful leg kick by Mitsatit. Just spun Miada around to end up in side control. Now, Miada trying to go for that leg lock, or they're trying to go for a single leg, but it got pushed away by Mitsatit. Now we're starting to see that forward pressure of Mitsatit. Miado's got to be careful because his back's up against the cage now.
Pongsiri Mitsatit, who made his debut in the cage in 2014. Made his one championship debut in May of last year. A fantastic knockout over Sekwane in Bangkok. Followed that up with a win over Wushu champion Rabin Catalan in March this year, who he knocked out in 15 seconds remaining in the first round. Can he keep the momentum going here tonight with a knockout over Miada?
See Mitsatit just cutting off the angles. Every time Miado starts to move to the right, you can see Mitsatit slide to the left. And he gets a yellow card for lack of action. I think he's exhausted, though. He really put everything he had into that first round, and now Mitsatit's picking him apart. He's eating up that leg, too.
That yellow card will either ignite Miada or deflate him even more. He is tired. And can Mitsatit capitalize? Miada backs up yet again. Mitsatit may be setting the right hand. Double leg from Miada. He's trying to change the game plan. He's trying to change the contest, but he's been fully mounted now.
Stop that.
Shimada said no more.
You can see him point to the eye. It looked like he just had enough. Something could have been wrong. That's the what he was. Look at that way he ate up that leg. Beautiful leg kick. That had to hurt. Spun him around. Here's the finish. Once Mitsatit got on top and he started to let a little bit go, it was a verbal submission. Miada had nothing left and was forced to give up.
Sensational from Pongsiri Mitsatit.
You feel the Mitsatit. Wrong with his Michael. I think something was wrong with his eye. He kind of winced when he hit him with that elbow, and that could have been it.
You feel that Mitsatit, maybe at the moment in his career, overshadowed by some of the bigger Thai stars here at one championship, like Shannon Wirachai or Dech Damrong. But after a performance like that, he is on the radar.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 23 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of verbal tap out, Pongsiri Mitsatit!
By way of verbal tap out, Pongsiri, the smiling assassin Mitsatit, maintains his undefeated record.
Opposite for these two though. Pongsiri wearing the white, orange and black shorts. And Catalan in the red. Big difference in body shape. Catalan muscular, thick. Pongsiri a little bit rangier.
Catalan's got heavy leg kicks. Pongsiri Mitsatit's got beautiful knees. Nice wide stance coming out of Pongsiri Mitsatit. We've seen in the past, Pongsiri Mitsatit's got good defensive wrestling. How's he going to handle his first takedown here? Well, immediately, Rabin Catalan jumps on the back of Pongsiri Mitsatit, gets one hook in, slides that second hook in. Now he's looking for a rear naked choke.
Be careful about punches to the back of the head. What started that was a heavy right hand from Catalan. Now, how could he work this through, Mitch?
The first thing Pongsiri Mitsatit's got to do is try to put his back on the mat. So he's got to try to turn and turn.
twist in Robin Catalan. They're going to go chest to chest. Good job by Pongsiri Mitsatit to possibly avoid their rear naked choke. He was able to pose back on and get back in the guard. Robin Catalan is going to try to play the late game here. He drops down and attacks the leg. This is what he wants.
Oh, that's the heel hold. We've seen him win multiple times this way before. It's all Pongsiri can do to unleash a hammer blow or two to try and distract him. But now he's concentrating on the hands that are suppressing that heel.
Good job by Pongsiri.
He can, but it's not over yet.
He's got to try to separate the hands. He's got to try to separate those hands. He can possibly turn, put his right foot on the butt of Robin Catalan and push off to create a little bit of space. But a good job by Pongsiri Mitsatit to avoid two bad positions right there.
And not only did he wriggle free, Mitch, but he went straight in for the right hand and now the knees to the body. Looks like there's been an illegal blow, which is, it looked like to me as if the fight had, as if the contest had been ended by legitimate knees to the ribs. Catalan, though, is clearly saying that he took a very central blow, an illegal blow, and the referee is in agreement with him. Just for a moment there, I thought it was all over.
It was those knees. That's where he said he wanted to go. He wanted to utilize the knees because that's where he felt he Robin Catalan had a hole in his guard, and he landed the second knee. I don't know about the first knee, but the second knee landed clean to the solar plexus. But it's that first knee that we have to take a look at.
Let's take a closer look. I think we've got a replay of the blows in question.
Look at that. He connects there on the right hand, presses him up against the K in the circle there. That, ooh.
Oh, that looks high. That looks very high. So far, I don't see anything illegal. That's difficult to see. We didn't get a good view of the third one.
It was the first one, Steve. It was the first one. It kind of went up, and then it finished on the body, but it was the way that it went up. It could have caught him in the groin.
A glancing blow, and the first contact you're saying could have been
that's what it is. Area.
All right, look, here's the lowdown. The athletes get 5 minutes for a medical examination to take place and for recovery.
Let's take another look at this. It was that first one, because watch, it goes up, his hands right there. See, it's going up.
Oh, yeah, I can see what you're saying, yeah.
See
yeah.
How it grazed?
It grazed,
the
yep.
cup on the way up into the body. But then it was two more knees, and that's probably what he's feeling right now, is those knees.
Yeah, but
possibly the first knee as well, because that's a groin shot. You can't, you know.
That first blow, the deeper impact certainly happened in a legal area, but as you say, it was a grazed blow from the very first point. Here's a second angle on it. Seemed to be in the illegal area. Oh, cringy.
Yeah, there's no question about it that it grazed the cup on the way up.
I'm in agreement with you.
Robin Catalan being the warrior that he is. I think there's a lot of Filipino fans here. He's got the support of.
Well, Pongsiri is getting his fans behind him, encouraging them to make a little bit of noise. Oh, he looks tired, doesn't he? He looks as if that's taken something out of him. But we know the Catalans, and we know they don't just stop, not in the tracks.
Look at it, Robin Catalan's ready to go. Let's do it again.
We had some entertainment before that happened. Bound to pick up where it left off.
But Pongsiri Mitsatit was correct. Both these guys' game plans played out perfectly in the first 2 minutes of this round.
Oh, the right hand from Catalan, but he was the one that went to the ground. Every blow that Mitsatit lands, this crowd goes crazy.
Pongsiri Mitsatit picks up a big strong weight. And a knee again lands to the body.
That's a bit of a risk, isn't it? Seven of those knees in again.
Pongsiri Mitsatit. See how Pongsiri Mitsatit puts his left leg in between the legs of Robin Catalan, which gives him a little bit better control.
This crowd having a great time. Every blow. Oh, the right uppercut just grazed. You're having difficulty seeing where Mitsatit lands. Just listen, because the crowd will tell you. 2:10 left in this opening round. We had that little stoppage for Catalan to recover from an illegal blow. The knees come raining in again.
Pongsiri Mitsatit could turn the corner here and take Robin Catalan down.
Oh, he's
but it was the rib, surely. That was high enough. Nothing illegal about that. And the knee did all the damage. It landed flush in the ribs. And the second that it landed, Catalan did not want to know anything more about it. He went down. Pongsiri Mitsatit goes straight over to pay his respects, offer his congratulations on what was a very, very entertaining contest. Let's take a look at the blows that did it.
He is so dominant inside the clinch. Look how he has that gable grip lock there inside the clinch. He's pulling down. That one lands right there above the chest, and
that
you can
the
just
one.
See Bobby Cantillon rumbles.
Just below the pectoral muscle.
Pongsiri Mitsatit calling his shot, going Nostradamus here in Bangkok, Thailand. And Colin says he wants the knees to the body for the knockout finish.
Shadow Wirachai is getting some circle side as well. Rika Ishige showing us how it was done. A perfect replay. What a way for these fans to enjoy the build-up to these two world title contests. Seeing one of their own win so emphatically against really a very, very game, Robin Catalan.
Robin Catalan had his moment. Pongsiri Mitsatit had to dig deep inside of himself to find that victory. He gave up some bad positions. Robin Catalan had that heel hook in deep, and then Pongsiri Mitsatit came back thundering with those knees.
Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yoshinori Umeki, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 5 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of knockout, Pongsiri Mitsatit!
These fans here at the Impact Arena going crazy with that home country win. Robin Catalan is no pushover, believe you me. Pongsiri Mitsatit improves his record now to 10-2